We bring you greetings and blessings, wonderful saints, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, from All Saints Cathedral in Babane. Today being the first Sunday after Easter, or the first Sunday after Resurrection, or as is also called in some areas, it is called Easter 2, and it is the 24th of April 2022. Our readings for today are found on page 37 of the lectionary, as well as page 232 of the prayer. And you have a service brought to you today by Dean Albert Lamini, Canon, Reverend Canon Thandekile Zulu, Reverend Sigudla, as well as Reverend Dumisani Mabuza. Today's service is going to be different in that you will only be getting our sermon as well as the collect and the prayers for today. You are going to later on get a full-blown service, which will be the confirmation service together with our bishop, the Right Reverend Darcy Lamin. But for now, you will only get a shortened form of our prayer, of our service for today. Our readings for today are as follows. First reading is from Acts chapter 5, verses 27 to verses 32. Psalm 118, verses 14 to 29. The second reading is from Revelation chapter 1, verses 4 to 8. And the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 31. And the canticle for today is the Song of the Church, the TDR, the Song of the Church. Let us pray our collect for today. God of mission, you raise Jesus Christ as the firstborn of the dead. By your Holy Spirit, empower us to witness to him, so that those who have not yet seen may come to believe in him who was and is to come, and who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our sermon for today is titled, Jesus Rose to Send Us Out. Jesus rose to send us out. As we have already received our readings for today, which have already been highlighted from Acts, from the Psalm, from Revelations, and also from the Gospel according to St. John, we have at this moment gone past our Lenten time of prayer and fasting, and we have, as we will remember and recall last week, gone on to a time when we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, as we acclaim that Jesus Christ is risen, Jesus Christ has conquered death, and we rightfully celebrated in the past weekend when we sang our glad hallelujahs, when we lit our Easter candle, and also we rang the bells to celebrate and remind the world that Jesus Christ is risen and Jesus Christ has conquered death. Indeed, we celebrate with the whole world that Christ has conquered death in order to give all people a chance for eternal life, and to also have all our sins forgiven through him, and we are then made joint heirs together with him in our Father's eternal kingdom. When we look at the readings for today, we first find the reading from Acts chapter 5, where we find the disciples standing before the council, which was asking them, why are you guys preaching about Jesus Christ's death and resurrection? Because by teaching about him, you are bringing the blood of his death upon our hands. We know very well that these are leaders that had all along plotted to kill Jesus Christ, and we have it on record that they are the ones that insurrected the people to shout and say, crucify Christ, crucify Christ. So indeed, in as much as they do not want to be seen or to be known to have had a hand in the death of Christ, we know that they did. And they didn't like Jesus Christ because he was bringing a teaching to the people that was liberating the people, a teaching that was challenging the conduct and the lives of those who were in power and authority at the time. And those people, those religious leaders, were not happy about them because Jesus Christ was challenging them. And we too, in our times that we live in, we need to know that we will always face criticism and ridicule when we stand for the truth and when we try to make the world aware of the things that are wrong that it is doing, people will stand up and say, no, 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 who are you to tell us this? And they will even take us or take you to jail just for speaking the truth and also for challenging them into doing the right things. However, the resurrection of Jesus Christ becomes to us a challenge to tell us and to make us aware that we should not succumb to those that will come and try to say we should keep quiet, we should not speak up the truth. But we should be like Jesus Christ and speak the truth. We should be like Jesus Christ and stand for the truth and be willing to make a difference and be willing to change. Bring about change in our world that is positive, change that is godly, that is going to make people come to Jesus Christ. Because God has called us, no matter what stature or age that you are, He has called us to come and be people that will bring about change. And the question that we'd like to ask is, are we able to, like the disciples, continue to stand for the truth? Because we are told that they said, we will not stop talking about this Christ. We will not stop talking about how you killed him and how he rose again from the dead. We will not stop talking the truth of God. Are we willing to stand up for the truth of God? Or when we face persecution, when we face ridicule, we are very quick to run away and say, let the people's will prevail instead of the will of God. Are we able to stand the pressure, or do we compromise the message of God Almighty? The disciples were adamant that as Christ has sent them, they are going to do what Jesus Christ had sent them to do, and they would do it with great zeal and without fear. They managed to overcome their fear of the Jews and religious leaders, and were willing to highlight that Christ is the Messiah. And we are called today to have that same boldness, Bazarani, in order to lead people to Christ. The psalm continues where last week's psalm ended, and it reminds us that God needs to be our strength and our salvation. Hence, we are not going to be people that are fearful, because we know that God is with us as we speak the truth. Christ, even though he knew the suffering that he would have to go through, went on to offer himself to God's service and for the salvation of humankind. Jesus Christ had the assurance that he would have the power to triumph over death. Just as God has given us so many different assurances that in our journey and in our walk with him, we shall overcome. We have been enabled through Christ, we have been enabled through the Holy Spirit to continue into uncharted waters and be able to experience something painful, just as Jesus Christ was able to continue into these waters, and he knew that the waters he was going into had a painful ending for him. Yet he stood up and said, I will stand for the truth. And that is why we are saying that Jesus Christ rose from the dead in order to set us out so that we can stand for the truth, just as he did, just as the disciples of old did. As the psalm puts it, Jesus Christ was aware that that doing the will of God was going to bring about pain to him. But it was important for him to fulfill this plan of God so as to save the world and bring it out into the presence of God and bring it back into the presence of God. Masarani, it is so true that God has love that endures forever for his people. And that is why he thought of a way, even though he saw it was going to be painful for him. He saw it was going to be to be humiliating to him, but he said, I will do this in order to save my people, so that I will be able to send them, so that they can go and speak to others, that they too should be able to be saved. And this, Masarani, should be an inspiration to us and help us to desire to work for God, to help us to desire to work hard in telling the world that Jesus Christ is risen, and that Jesus Christ is Lord, and he has come to set us free and to make us inheritors of God's eternal kingdom. And God has indeed placed eternal life as a reward to those who believe in him, to those who trust. go on to Revelation, we hear how John in the island of Patmos sat and got a revelation from God so as to empower us for service to God as we continue to prepare for the return of Jesus our Lord. John's vision was a reminder that Christ is alive, and not just alive, but that he is alive and has ascended into heavenlies to fulfill the work of God. This revelation of John reminds us that Christ is coming back with a reward for those who have been faithful to him and have continued in his service and ministry. So we need to be reminded now and again that we are sent by God to do great exploits for him. Indeed, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is there to encourage us to tell the world more about him, and to also carry out the work of God, and also tell the world about the work of Christ that he fulfilled to the end, without letting go, but standing for the truth that was there awaiting him to be revealed as the Son of God. And today we know that Jesus Christ is the beginning and the end, and that we need to allow him to use us for his glory, and to bring back the world to himself, so that the world may grow in him. When we move to our gospel reading, we realize how after the death of Christ, the disciples were so fearful, and they had to hide so that they do not become crucified like Jesus Christ was. And in today's reading, Christ appears before them. And as he appears, he tells them that he brings peace. And this was peace which they greatly needed. Whatever it is that we need in our lives as we serve the Lord, let us know and let us be assured, Bazalwane, that God Almighty will prevail and will bring an answer to our problems. Today, many of us are filled with fear when we are called to serve God, or when we are called to witness to the power of God. We need to be reminded that Christ has overcome the greatest fear, which is death. Hence, no other fear should hold us back from serving God. We are called to believe what God has said to us, even if we do not have tangible evidence of who God is or what God has said. We rely on his word. We rely on faith to say what God has spoken, because it is written in his word. We believe and understand that that is going to happen. Jesus Christ speaks to Thomas today and tells him how important it is for him to believe without having seen. And even to us, Jesus Christ is saying, we need to be able to believe before we have seen. We need to have our faith in order for us to be able to serve God. As we are called to tell the world that Christ is alive, may we have the confidence to believe those things which we have not seen, but have heard from God and have heard from his word. And let us trust in him to help us in our journey with him and in serving him. And as we see how the disciples later on in the first reading that we had, how they then became bold and powerful and were able to even stand up to the authorities and the powers that be to stand up for the truth, because they had received from Christ that call to go forth and serve him. Just as you and I today are called to go forth and serve the Lord. As John says, the word has been written that we may believe that Christ is the Messiah and the Son of God. We are called today to go forth and declare this news to the world, to help the world to get saved. Christ did not rise from death that we may celebrate and sit down, but that we may become heralds of this good news to the world. May God help us, Bazalwane, to have faith and courage to witness these things, especially as we declare that Jesus Christ is alive and he is risen. May you continue to have a great and fantastic time as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, you raised up Jesus Christ as your faithful witness and the firstborn of the dead. By your Holy Spirit, help us to witness to him, so that those who have not yet seen him may come to believe in him who is and was and is to come. Glorious Lord, salvation of the world through the death and the resurrection of your Son. Give strength to our praise, and let our hearts and mouths be filled with the joy of your wondrous works. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God Almighty, you stop the fires of your churches as light and darkness of this world. As we gather in the Spirit on the Lord's Day, comfort and embolden your loving ones to serve in your presence and to cherish the words you have written to your churches. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, your Son visited disciples heading away for fear of the Jews, as well as John when he was exiled by the Romans to Patmos. Sustain all your disciples in the throes of persecution. Visit them with your Easter gospel, and give them their portion in the resurrection unto life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God of hosts, you have added believers to the Lord Jesus in all times and places, from those receptive and hostile alike. Shepherd the nations and bring all peoples to embrace the gospel of the resurrected Christ. Keep the wicked rulers and break their power, that all would be brought to the feet of Jesus in worship. Lord, in your mercy. Oh, great Jesus, even the shadows of your apostles brought him into the afflicted people of Jerusalem. As we rest under the shadow of your wings, heal your afflicted servants and children, that they would rejoice in your steadfast love. Comfort those who mourn, and encourage those who have lost faith. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful Lord, your Son greets his disciples with peace despite their sins against him. Make us confident in his mercy toward us and gladden our hearts as he comes to us in his body and blood to forgive. Renew and strengthen us. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, we give thanks for your gifts to the church for the past years. Chiefly do we thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ, who alone is our salvation. By his death, you have atoned for our sins. By his resurrection, you have justified us. And by his word and Holy Spirit, you have brought the gospel of peace to us. We give thanks to that. You have richly and daily forgiven the sins of believers and given us sacraments for our edification, not unto us, but unto your name. O Lord, be glory. Lord, in your mercy. We implore you, O Lord, to sanctify and keep the congregations, schools, and organizations together with all our people in the truth. Your word is truth. Preserve us from false teaching. Bring us to repentance from every place where love or sin has faltered. Grant us and our children bold and steadfast hearts to remain faithful to this confession and church, suffering all rather than to fall away from it, and unite us with all Christians in a true confession of Jesus Christ, in whom the world has redemption, the forgiveness of sins. To you alone be all glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. In Jesus Christ. Amen.